Welcome back to another episode of PTV. I'm Luke Hoover.
And I'm Annie Weisar. There are some exciting changes coming for our future journalism and video students, as those programs are making a joint effort to take over the operations of MyPhillipsCountyOnline.com. Luke, you follow them on Facebook, right?
Of course. Joel Ford gives us more detail on how students are starting to make the transition already.
And good morning and welcome to a tadpole.
The PTV class has learned some exciting news for the upcoming year.
Mrs. Sides' journalism classes and my video classes are teaming together to basically take over the operations of My Phillips County Online.
Students think that this will be a big step towards the future.
It's important because then our school and all the students within can get kind of help within the community and also learn about how to run a business and marketing and stuff like that.
I think this is an awesome opportunity for our students at PHS to get some hands-on learning on how the ins and outs of a business runs, because basically this is a business.
Many are looking forward to what's to come.
I'm looking forward just to seeing all the guests come in and learning about what's going on in the community.
I'm looking forward to just seeing how the students can learn and take advantage of this awesome opportunity and seeing that whatever may grow from it. You know, we have a lot to learn, Mrs. Sides and I do, to figure out how this is all going to work, but we're excited about what this might mean for our students.
For PTV, this is Joel Ford.
I've learned a lot from filming the Tadpole. It's a good place to find out what's going on in the community.
Speaking of events in Phillips County, the Hansen Museum in Logan is displaying an art show of local high school talent. Maverick gives us a glimpse of that show. Take a look.
The Hansen Museum in Logan, Kansas, is giving local high school students something to be proud of.
We hope it's a source of pride for them. For many art students, this is an equivalent to getting to start at a basketball game. This is their, hitting the shot before the buzzer goes off. This is what they do instead of going to practice. They create, and we just wanted to give them a showcase, a place to let the people, the public, see what they are doing with their time.
Students are happy that they get to show their work and have fun doing it.
It's a good way to express yourself. I do art it's more of experimenting. If I see something cool online, I'll try to recreate it. And if I can, I'll keep going.
The Hansen hopes for students to continue creating and to continue their art.
The high school art show, we hope to inspire students to continue creating post-high school. We just want to fuel their passion for art and give them a professional gallery experience here.
Students show respect to those who have led them into their newborn passions.
I've been trying to get into art a lot more recently. My sister does art, and she's been trying to teach me how to do art for quite a while. And since I've been doing more art classes, I thought this would be a pretty good place to come to.
For PTV, this is Maverick Hedrick.
The art students aren't the only ones displaying their talents. On Sunday, the Amendment of PHS hosted their annual benefit. Kiara Fitzpatrick gives us a recap on that.
Here comes PHS Amendment as they perform a variety of songs in this year's benefit concert.
Our theme this year was, it was loosely based on musicals. Most of the music was Broadway music. A lot was from movies and stuff too. But it was supposed to be things also that kind of surrounded our feelings about the year of COVID.
Fly me to the moon, let me play among the stars.
Although all the songs were performed well, some songs seemed to stand out the most.
My favorite song to sing was definitely Remember Me. You know, be able to do our last benefit, have a little piece kind of devoted to us. Most of us have been in it for 4 years, so it was nice to have a kind of conclusion to our amendment careers.
Remember we made an arrangement when you went away.
The amendment members were pleased with their performance.
Everyone did awesome, and I am incredibly proud of today's performance and how it turned out. So,
members took the opportunity to thank their teachers for their help throughout the year.
Yeah, it's just basically one big thank you for everything, because they've done more than I could ever say, and I am so lucky to have been a part of their life for 4 years. So.
I'm really going to miss our seniors. A lot of them thought as eighth graders they weren't going to make it into amendment, and now here they are, almost all of them, all 4 years, and the ones that we got later, they're outstanding too. They've really demonstrated leadership, honestly, throughout their 4 years. And so this year was kind of the pinnacle. And I'm really, really proud of them.
I'm definitely going to miss the bond between all of us that we share. Amendment is we're all very close, we're very tight-knit, and we're more like a family than, you know, like a team or a class. So I think I'm definitely going to miss that kind of bond of friendship that we've been building for 4 years.
For PTV, this is Kiara Fitzpatrick.
Although the Amendment was able to perform in a live concert with spectators, the same can't be said for this year's regional and state music contests.
They were still able to compete, but this year it was quite a bit different, as you'll see in our next segment.
Because of our current situation, it is no surprise that this year's vocal contest was done virtually.
It was really different because we had to record our ensemble and we had to send in our video instead of going there in person and performing in front of the churches.
Students have different ways to prepare for contest.
To prepare for contest, I just practiced every day with the piano with Miss Munyon and Miss Still until I felt like I could record and have a good recording.
Although the new format was challenging, the students adapted well.
I thought overall the experience was good. It's more fun to get on the bus and go to contest in person, but because of COVID and the things that we can't do because of that, this was the next best thing.
Although contest took a different approach this year, there was still a positive outcome.
I do miss being in person, but at the same time, it was nice to not have to take a day off of practicing for benefit. But all in all, I feel like it was a good experience.
For PTV, this is Eva Armit. That's a good question.
Good afternoon, friends. Today, we're going to start off with a would you rather. So today we have, would you rather live somewhere sunny or snowy? Discuss with your partners. Oh, friend. This is a discussion. You discuss with your partner.
What? I didn't know we started. What's the question?
Would you rather live somewhere snowy or sunny?
What about you?
I like playing out in the snow, so probably snowy.
Where would you rather live?
I don't know. I'm inside all the time anyway. I guess snowy. Maybe better chance of a snow day that way.
Do you have more discussion to add, or is that it? All right, friend, you tried your best. Oh, friends, we are in the fourth 9 weeks of this school year. We are almost done. How is it that you all still get confused about which hour you're in? This one's third hour, this one's fourth hour. Please turn all of your assignments into the correct trays. Thank you. Oh yes, that's gonna be such a good photo for my Twitter. Okay, great. Friends, has anyone seen my phone? I seem to have lost my phone. Where's my phone? You guys? Oh! There it is. Why didn't you tell me, friend? It was right there.
What were you looking for?
My phone.
Oh, sorry.
The forensics team has been competing virtually throughout most of the season, but recently they were able to compete in a traditional in-person tournament. Here's a closer look.
The forensics team finished up the regular season with a meet in Oakley. The students qualified more entries to state at this meet, and the team placed second altogether. Top placers were Nick Skemper, who placed first in extemp and informative, Zoe Dinkle, who placed first in poetry and third in humorous,
Jeremy Ford and Theo Kazee, who plays first in IDA, Jordan McDiffitt, who plays second humorous solo, Jeremy Ford, who plays second in poetry, and Eva Arment and JC Roth, who plays second in duet. Being able to compete in person made this final regular season tournament special. The forensics team will wrap up their season with the state competition on Saturday, May 1st. For PTV, this is Ava Skimper.
Although spring is a busy time for concerts, art shows, and forensics tournaments like in our previous stories, students are still, well, students. And there is a lot going on in the classrooms of PHS.
In Mrs. Sushland's physics class, students are putting their critical thinking skills to the test with a new project. Amanda Davison explains.
PHS physics students are combining work with play as they make toys to learn about types of energy.
The students are trying to build either a toy or a tool that uses like a solar power or a hand crank or something for its energy.
Me and my partner went with a boat and we use solar panels to charge rechargeable batteries that uses it to make a motor turn.
As students build their projects, they are learning a variety of skills.
I've been learning lots of things about how circuits work and how some things won't work and some things do work and everything like that.
I've learned how to correctly solder electronic components together and how electricity flows through different kinds of circuits.
Overall, students enjoy learning physics while completing this assignment.
I really like doing this project. It's really cool being able to just learn about the different circuits and how certain things work.
For PTV, this is Amanda Davison.
That physics project looks like fun. We don't do that in my physics class.
Luke, what physics class are you in?
Physical education? You know, like PE?
Please tell me you know that's not the same thing.
Yeah, sure. Whatever. Here's a story about physical education, which is just as important.
The recreational sports class has been utilizing a different facility to learn additional sports.
The building's through First St. John in Kensington. I've got some friends in Kensington that had mentioned it to me once. I used to play racquetball quite a bit, and we were just visiting one day, and they had mentioned that there was one in Kensington, so kind of got the idea that maybe I could use it for one of my classes sometime.
Students enjoy getting to play games that they don't normally get the chance to play.
I really enjoyed air hockey because it's not a game that you can find really around town to play.
Yeah, I had a good time over there.
Yeah, I had a lot of fun going with my class and being able to experience just going to a new place.
Mrs. Dinkle hopes to continue this activity in future years.
I'd love to do it again, and I would like to thank Pastor Hudson of the church in Kensington for allowing us to do that. He didn't charge us anything, and he really encouraged us to use the facility when we could.
For PTV, this is Corey Genders.
Come on, Kyla. Let's wrestle.
No,
come
Dad,
here.
Stop.
Come
you
here.
Hurt me.
Come
ow.
Here.
My hair.
Come here.
Ow.
Stop. Don't be a wuss.
Ow. Okay. I'm good.
Kyla, you're getting fat. Get down and do some push-ups.
I am not, Dad.
Get down and give me 10.
Dad, I'm not going to wrestle.
Yeah, you are. You're going to be a state placer.
What?
Further down. No. All the way down. Do it with me sitting on you.
You're too heavy.
Okay,
Dad. I want to show you how to do a firebird. Okay, I've been practicing it, and I'm pretty good at it.
Okay.
Okay, now you watch. It's kind of technical. I want you to watch and try it, okay?
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to step, I'm going to jump in the air, we'll kick my leg back.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. Now you try it, Dad.
I can do a better phoenix than that.
No, Dad, it's called a firebird.
No, it's a phoenix. Emmy does it really good. Emmy does it better than you.
Okay. Now we're gonna do a turn.
Okay.
Okay, we're gonna step and rotate on our foot and turn all the way around.
Okay.
Okay, all right, like this. Okay, your turn. Now,
no,
try it.
No, that was good.
Try it without being so dramatic.
I can do it double.
You're so dramatic, Dad.
I could be a better pacer than you.
Whatever.
Now it's time for our PTV sports update.
Hey, Panther fans, time for another PTV Sports Report. I'm Jeremy Ford.
And I'm Joel Ford. Our spring sports season is underway, and our teams are off to a strong start.
PTV's Luke Coover traveled with the golf team to Smith Center to bring you a look at how the team did at that tournament. Take a look.
The PHS golf team traveled to compete in the Smith Center golf tournament last Thursday.
Today we played golf in Smith Center at the Invitational here. Team's looking good. We were improving every tournament. We cut 95 strokes off our last tournament at Oberlin, so we're improving every day.
Battling the challenging weather conditions, the Panthers look to build and improve from their previous tournament in Oberlin.
So far, on two tournaments, Ty's won both of them, so that's kind of the highlight. Team-wise, we got fourth at Oberlin, and we won the tournament here at Smith Center.
Senior Ty Sides won his second tournament in a row as he placed first with a score of 81. Freshman Tyler Davis also scores in the top five with a fourth place finish and a score of 94. The Panthers finished the tournament with a first place team score. For PTV, this is Luke Hoover.
Now on to track, where our boys and girls track teams are doing well too. Last Friday, they competed at the Norton Invitational. Colette Kennedy was there to bring you this report.
Runners are making their mark and getting set for a successful track season as they competed last Friday at Norton.
I thought overall both teams competed really, really well. On the girls' side, they won it. We kind of had set some goals, and they kind of went out and achieved it. And for a first meet, I thought boys and girls competed very, very well.
Having no season last year, athletes have one thing on their mind, making it to state.
My season goals are just to try and PR every meet and at least one thing, and at the end of the season to get to state and place there. And then team goals are just for all of us to do really good, try to win more meets, and hopefully a lot of people get to go to state.
For the season, I would definitely like to make it to state this year. I felt like I maybe could have last year, but with track getting canceled, it was a big bummer. So especially this year, I'd really like to try to get to state. I think that's the ultimate goal for me.
The track team competed really well, bringing home several top place finishes.
Some of the top placers today, Ava Skimper, I think she was first in all of her events. Austin Durking was second in the shot put. I think she did really well. Nick Skimper in the triple jump was second. Boys 4x4 was first. Those are just a few off the top of my head. Rhett Shelton in the 800.
Additional highlights include, on the boys' side, Kagan Keaton in pole vault, Nick Skimper in the 400 and the 4x4 team. On the girls' side, Heather Skimper in the 400 and the 800, the 4x4 team and the 4x1 team. For PTV, this is Colette Kennedy.
For a long time, track and golf were the only sports for the spring season at PHS, but it looks like that might change.
What? Are we finally getting baseball?
No.
Soccer?
Nope.
Well, then what?
Find out in this next segment.
There is a new activity for PHS students to participate in, and that is esports.
Esports are basically competitive video games. Basically, you can take your game to a next level and see how you stack up against competition from around the area. And instead of just telling your friends how good you are, you can kind of go out and show it.
Many students are excited about the prospect of esports coming to the school.
A couple schools had them as clubs, you know, I was kind of intrigued, and I started doing some more research, and I noticed that they actually have tournaments, nationwide tournaments. And I noticed they also gave out scholarships, so depending on how well you were or how good you were, you could actually, I guess, receive money to go on to college.
Students have the opportunity to compete in multiple different games.
There's Fortnite, which is kind of like a battle royale, player versus player, or team versus team game. There's Madden, which is basically just a football game. Go out as your favorite NFL team and try to win. And then there is Rocket League, which is basically like soccer, but with cars, and you can make modifications to your cars, help them go faster, give them extra boosts.
The school, however, has faced many challenges in bringing esports to PHS.
The biggest problem is we have so many kids that really enjoy the esports or the gaming side of things, but they're also active in other sports like basketball and track, and it's kind of hard to find time where these kids can actually compete. The other problem was, once we did get signed up, you know, we had to jump through several hoops. We had to sign up for esports, and we had to make play VS accounts. All this was all set up and done, and everything seemed to be working. And the first few times we sat down to try to get logged in to play a game, the two teams couldn't communicate. We could not communicate with the opponents. The opponents could not communicate with us.
Despite this, the school is optimistic about the future of esports.
I know Russell has a club that I think they really want to get started in on it. Oakley has the same, similar to what we're doing. Logan, just down the road here, they're trying to do the same thing. But as far as at the next level, like at Keisha, I see this becoming, eventually, one of these days, it could be a recognized activity. I know you'll have a lot of schools that are against it just because they do not want to pull away from your basketball and your track and wrestling. And I understand that. And that is not my intention. And that's why I made it so that if we were to start one, it would be mostly evenings, so that kids could actually do those after-school sports and do the gaming.
For PTV, this is Nick Skemper.
What do you think, Joel? Are esports real sports?
I don't want to start that debate. Instead, we have one more sports report for you that is outside of our traditional sports coverage.
That's right. Sports aren't just for junior high and high school students. They're for everyone.
Our Phillipsburg soccer organization gives even the youngest athletes a chance to have fun playing sports. Take a look.
Phillipsburg's Little Kids Soccer Program continues the tradition of giving the area youth a healthy introduction to sports.
Well, obviously, I think it's important that they get out and they get a chance to run around and also to play as a team and also just to learn a different sport we don't have in our schools here, and I think it benefits them in many ways.
Although official scoring is not kept, players still get excited about scoring goals.
In the first half, I think we scored two goals, and then the second half, we scored one more goal.
However, the main goal of this program is to encourage kids to have fun while playing sports.
I love soccer because you have a lot of fun and you just get to run around.
That you get to kick the ball and have fun.
I love soccer because you get to see friends and you get to be on teams.
The players aren't the only ones who enjoy the games.
It's a lot of fun being around the kids. It's fun to come out here, just kind of see the smiles and just to teach them something.
For PTV, this is Kay Pockabeer.
One, two, three. Bananas!
That's all the time we have for sports today. I'm Joel Ford.
And I'm Jeremy Ford. Go Panthers!
Emma, are you working?
Yeah. See?
I told ya.
Get off that.
Just listening to music.
Okay.
Hey, homie, what's for supper tonight? I'm starving.
Nothing for you.
What? I don't eat forever.
Put your mask on over your nose.
It is.
Get out of my personal space.
There's the igneous rock, the sedimentary, and the metamorphic.
Oh my God, you're so embarrassing.
Emma.
What?
Be quiet.
Do we take time off your phone? But I'm just saying.
I'm gonna take time off your phone, Emma.
Hey.
So Luke, you remember the segment we showed earlier in this episode about the student art show?
Sure, I remember that.
Well, it turns out we have another special artist here at PHS that most people don't really know about.
Oh really? Who's that?
Well, you're gonna find out. Watch this.
Hello, I'm Bob Roth, and welcome back to The Joy of Painting. Thank you for inviting me back again. And now I'm going to show you the colors that we have for today. Blossoming pink, orange orange, titanium white, red, midnight black, and really yellow. I'm going to start by getting a touch of orange and the smallest tad bit of pink from the sunset. Yep, just like that. Then we're going to grab a touch of titanium white, the slightest little touch, load up your brush, and just dab it on there. Whatever amount you're feeling is the appropriate amount. Orange, slightest tad of pink, just tap it. Tap, tap, tap. Blend it in. Then we're gonna grab some of the midnight black. Just the slightest bit, don't want too much. There are no accidents when painting, just happy accidents. Now we're gonna go back in with the pink and orange mix. Just like that. Now we need to touch up the sky a little bit. We're gonna grab some titanium white. Now a little bit more pink to settle it out. Dab, dab, dab. A couple more trees to add in. We need some more happy little trees. Just like that. A tad bit more orange and pink before we finish up. And there. Thank you for joining me for the Joy of Painting with Bob Ross, and I will see you next time.
That wraps up another episode of PTV. I'm Luke Hoover.
And I'm Annie Weisar.
Stay classy, Phillipsburg High.